for the abortion because she was suffering so badly afterwards. And you know what their counseling was? Think about this when you're feeling bad. Think about that child that's keeping you awake at night. Think about wanting to go out on a night out and you can't because you have no babysitter. Let that be your consolation. How appalling is that? I hear these stories all of the time of these airy-fairy counseling that they get, that they're, it's ridiculous. Many people, as it's been said before, are alive today because of the Eighth Amendment to our Constitution. And I know now that if I had been living in Ireland back then when I was pregnant and had that precious time to reflect, it would make all the difference and my child could be alive today. Because of my choice, I ended the life of my unborn child and generations to come. There's a space in my family that can never be filled. So don't believe the lies. And we also hear today, you know, this awful term, fatal fetal abnormality. I get women and men, husbands and wives, couples coming on my retreats who are given that diagnosis, and they have a very complicated grief. The pain and the suffering of those parents who believe those lies and who weren't given any alternatives and who rushed in and had the abortion. I've also, by the way, had women on my weekends who were raped and had abortions. And now they're grieving and wishing they had their babies back. Why? Because the birth of the child heals the effect of the rape. But with the other side, pro-abortion people are using that today. Oh, if a woman is raped, she should have an abortion. I've heard so many people say it. Why should the baby die for the sins of the father? Why not punish the father? Stop rape instead of killing the unborn child and the mother's womb. Silent on this issue, and in the smallest way we can be voiceless in this. We can speak to friends, we can speak to people in our workplace, people who are very openly pro-choice, and by being kind and gentle and compassionate we can give that message across, if not in a judgmental or a condemning way, but in a loving way. I have a dream, and you know that dream fills my heart each day, to have more women to stand here with me. I have a dream that in my lifetime women and men here in Ireland, and indeed all over the world, suffering after an abortion, will stand as one and break their silence and insist that their stories of loss and regret be heard. So I thank you all for being here today. Thank you for taking the time to listen. And if there's anybody out there who knows someone who's been damaged or hurt by abortion, Rachel's Vineyard, Women Heart. Women Heart is a wonderful organisation that was set up as a portal, a website, a portal for women to contact us anonymously. And only today, when I was having my lunch in town, I got a call of distress from a young woman who'd had an abortion a couple of years ago. Has to give up her job, her life is destroyed. I hear those on a regular basis, the stories of pain and suffering. But there is hope and there is healing. And we can make a difference by having our voices heard today. The good can come from that situation, because if I hadn't had that abortion, even though it's a dreadful thing and I would give my life to have my child back, I stand here before you speaking the truth of my own abortion experience. So God bless you all. It's so heartening to